down on his shoulders. His shoulders weren't relaxed, they were active, they were ready to receive the bar.
But we need this barbell as close to that frontal plane as possible. Go ahead and get that bar up there. As close to the frontal plane as possible to have that balance there for balance, and then also for lining up these joints and be able to stack the bones or stack that weight. So notice where we want this upper arm. We want it parallel to the ground.
So John's saying, this is as good as I can do. So what I can do as a coach, making sure with his consent, is kind of come in, grab the PVC, pull down to his shoulders, and help drive his elbows up. Now I can't stay here the whole time while he squats, but what we can probably guess, you can relax for a second, so with a little bit of weight, that's probably gonna sit down on his shoulders. His shoulders weren't relaxed, they were active, they're ready to receive the bar. He's got a lot of tightness in those lats, pecs, maybe a rear delt. So maybe put him on a little bit of a mobility program. You guys have foam rollers at your gym, or even the lacrosse balls. Maybe get him to do a little bit of mobility in that area and see if he can't free that up.
The only way I can get my elbows up is if I really drive that PVC pipe down with my chin.
Totally.
So is that okay?
Yeah. Because
my head kind of drops down a little bit.
Yeah, exactly.
Because so I don't have that. You know,
is it okay to compromise that head position a tiny bit to get that chin down? And it's really just more to get the point across that we want bar PVC on shoulders. As long as you get across, hey guys, this is just so we can get the feel of it. Remember the Frankenstein squat? Now we need it to happen here. Use a little cheat, I would say. Let's get back in that position. So as much as you can, bring that chin down on it and force those elbows up.
Okay.